in a couple hours.
Okay.
Grilling is for the hunters, not the gatherers. We don't take advice from gatherers when we're doing grilling. See, there's no smoke coming out of it. We're fine. Gatherers don't understand us. Us hunters, it's in our instinct. We know it's fine.
With your new love, don't be fooled thinking this is the last you'll find. But they never stood in the dark with you, love. When you take me in your arms and drive me slowly out of my mind, kiss me. So kiss me, kiss me. Make me tell you I'm in love with you. Kiss me, kiss me. When you do, I know that you will miss me. Miss me, if we ever say adieu. So kiss me, kiss me. Tell you I'm in love with you. Never, never, never let me go. Never, never, never
let me go. I am just a poor boy, though my story is seldom told. I squandered my resistance for a pocket full of mumbles, such are promises. All lies and jest, still the man hears what he wants to hear and disregards the rest. When I left my home and my family, I was no more than a boy in the company of strangers, in the quiet of the railway station, when scared. They know, seeking out the poor. for the quarters where the ragged people go, looking for the places only they would know. Tyler Nye. Asking only workmen's wages, I come looking for a job, but I get no offers. Just to come home from the wars on 7th Avenue. I do declare there were times when I was so lonesome I took some comfort there. La 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 la. City winters are bleeding me, bleeding me. Go on. In the clearing stands a boxer and a fighter by his trade, and he carries the reminders of every glove that laid him down or cut him till he cried out in his anger and his shame. I am leaving, I am leaving, but the fighter still remains.
Special tribute to Colonel Show upon his retirement from active duty and the Air Force after 25 years of commissioned service. The presiding official for today's ceremony is Air Vice Marshal Kim Osborne, who is the Australian Defense Attaché, Embassy of Australia, and head of the Australian Defense Staff in Washington, D.C. Colonel Schoen is joined today by his wife, Tina, and sons, Brandon and Jason. And the welcome surprise is Colonel Schoen's parents flew in today from Ohio, their phone sentence flew into Ohio to meet Colonel Schoen's aunt and hear a surprise for them for the ceremony, which is pretty neat. Welcome.
Being here today, it's a great time of celebration. I want to sort of break this time in three parts. The first is to welcome some very honored guests. The Trump family, thank you very much for being here and everything, and also for a very special guest, my son, my father, who seems to be showing up in everyone's past. Our past was 2 years ago out in the desert, and I didn't even realize that the path also crossed another one of our Air Force officers here throughout his career. Not our heavy years here. The other thing is, I'm going to talk a little bit about farewell show just for a second, because we already did his farewell and said great things about him, but we didn't have a gift to present, because the gift is also a little bit of a retirement gift too. So if I could have that, and you can come on up here, Chris. If you'd please accept this, shows a little bit of not only his going away, which would have his wings and the coins, all the services, plus the joint coins up on top. It also shows his ranks on the side here. The picture of us, we'll probably cover up that picture of us just to have this nice plaque. This way you'll never forget it. So, congratulations. Thank you.
And when I was invited on today, I was just sort of holding on to it. it's nice to see those people among those people. The certainly built into a bit of Spice Aviator there. He stayed in Bergstrom after our back was constructed in 1988. And I bounced back into him again in 88 when I came back for a foreign competition. But as you would have heard from his biography there, he was selected to go and become an instructor for the basic navigator training there at the Mayfair. And I believe he's an absolute gem out there, a good role model. And I imagine he learned a few tricks from when he was on ROTC. He wasn't subsidized there, so he only got $100 a month. Wasn't on a scholarship. Imagine he taught the undergraduate navigators how to get by on $100 a month. You drink bowl with the walking on test stuff. But I'm sure you're a great role model out there. And plenty of friends around the Air Force Science College people that respect you greatly. You heard that he went to personnel training set. He ran out of aeroplanes there. The Air Force was retired in the early 90s. And not everyone went on to a better type of aeroplane to another type of aeroplane. Many people had to retire at that time. And I think Charlie indicated there that they were doing a lot of coming down. So to Chris's credit, either he was an absolute fantastic candidate for the F-15E, or being in the Air Force personnel center, he managed to learn records. Ago, and I met General Mattis, the commander of the Duke, on Monday. and both those members are very proud of what your team brings to the project here and what you've done with us and us with us on. It's a personal thanks for the job of that. So thank you for that. All I can really say finally is that over the years I've gone into you regularly. I've known many of you for years, many of your supporters. And to all of them, you've been an absolute fantastic role model. You've been a great officer, a great aviator, but more importantly, you've been a great wife and a friend. So thank you very much for that. And as a small token of appreciation, I have a small gift for you. It's a fighting instrument from Australia called the boomerang. It predates the United States Air Force by about a few thousand years. But I must admit, it's one of not as effective as the UAV or probably the Predator or the Reaper. But this is what they use to go and hunt their prey and obviously to fight some big wars years ago in Australia. But most importantly, even though it's to do with war, it comes back. And I hope I'll be able to see you that you'll come back in years and that there's always a place in our home for you and team. But thank you very much.
Please rise for reading of the citation of the Company of the War and Defense Superior Service Medal. Now we invite Mrs. Tina Show to the stage for a very special recognition of her personal contributions. Air Vice Marshal Oscar will present Mrs. Show with the Airport Certificate of Appreciation. Ladies and gentlemen, today's honoree, retired Christopher